Hi, I'm Bill Sweeney from chillertone.com, cryogenic music technology. At the end of the video, check out the credits so you can visit our website and find out why we believe cryogenics can make a serious difference to your tone. Today we're going to be looking at changing the pickups on this Stratocaster-like guitar. And we're going to do that using a few... Now, when you're soldering, it's very important to tin the wires because too often you can spend ages trying to solder a cable that's not been tinned. But by tinning it, you're pre-coating it with solder and therefore it's going to stick a whole lot quicker when we come to fix it into position. So I've got my soldering iron, just clean the tip off, and I'm now going to tin the lead wire. Okay, what's going on? Okay, that's one tinned. Into the other one. Okay, so that's all nicely tinned now. And simply come over to the third tag, as we've already established that's going to be the tag we're going to use. And okay, and simply solder that onto the tag. Hold it till it's gone hard. And the same again for the earth. I'm just being very careful with this one because there is a lot of solder on this connection. And the one thing I want to avoid is a dry joint. A dry joint is where the component sticks, or the lead wire sticks, but it's not very secure and it provides a very poor electrical connection, and therefore it actually lets go later on. Okay, so we just trim this off now, and there you go, we've replaced the first pickup. I'm now going to move on to the middle pickup. Now, to desolder this one, the lead wire goes to the second from the left, and the earth obviously goes to the ground second one. Okay. And that should be relatively easy to remove now there. Okay, so that's the lead gone. Now just looking at this, looks quite embedded there. I might have a little bit of difficulty in this out. There you go. So again, I'm going to turn the plate over, and holding the back. Okay, so that's out. Remove the screw and the spring. Other end. Supporting the pickup. Okay, so we're at another point here. Remove the screw, feel for the spring behind, and remove that. Okay, so we've now removed our second pickup. So I'm now going to refit the middle position pickup. Always being gentle. Let me start to wind that in. Second screw and spring. Again, not worrying about the height of the pickup at the moment, we're just interested in securing it into the scratch plate. Okay, so turn this over again. And we're going to do the same thing again. We're going to measure off the length of conductor. And what I like to do is, wherever possible, is to route the conductors so that they follow the same path. I always think that's a little bit neater. So that one, I can cut that off there. Okay. And this one, I'd like that one to come around and follow there into the second hole. That's very similar. So I'm going to cut that one here. If you're inexperienced, I would always recommend leaving a little bit of slack, because if you've removed the slack, there's nothing you can do. You just have to extend the whole cable. So having cut the conductors to length, we then need to trim them back so that we can start soldering the conductors. Okay, one trim back. Okay. One. Two. Okay. So now we're ready to tin the ends. Always clean the tip of your soldering iron and tin the leads. There we are, lovely one. Two. Okay, so now we bring that one round to be fixed. Again, apply it to the connection. Solder. And that's gone off. Okay, done. That's the lead wire connected to the switch. Now we connect the earth or ground to the volume pot. Okay, so that's the ground. So now I've only got the bridge pickup to put back. Lovely. So I'll now crack on and get the bridge pickup sorted. So now we've replaced all the pickups and we've finished off the wiring. Everything's gone to plan. There's no real major drama there. The key thing was we kept it simple by not taking all the pickups out at once. We took them one by one and we worked our way along the scratch plate. So now we ought to think about repositioning the scratch plate back onto the body of the guitar. And so that means removing